Good morning and thank you for joining me. I'm out here in the Bluebell woods near our home in East Staffordshire, and it's just lovely to be outside. As you can hear, I'm surrounded by birds. I've seen squirrels already, and it's a lovely wood. And as you can see, I'm going to be in the middle of the woods here painting. There's a construction over there that is going to be my subject. It looks a bit like a dinosaur skeleton. I quite like that. So I've set up, I'm in amongst the weeds here, I'm not in the bluebells because you're not meant to walk on them. But we'll see how we go anyway. See you later.
I've got the basic composition in using a mixture of French ultramarine and burnt sienna. Burnt sienna thinned down with some Sansodor, and I've sort of placed where that main tree is and then the shelter kind of coming out of it. Next I've got to get some of the background elements in, the sky and the trees. I was hoping the sky might lighten up a bit before I start painting it, so I've been kind of waiting a little bit, and it is actually getting slightly brighter, so I think that will be good, and that will bring out the shadows and the darker tones in the trees. It's just lightening up now, so I'll do a bit more. So there's a lot of clouds in the sky today, so the light keeps coming and going, so you have to kind of be on your mettle a little bit. It's rather lovely because it's giving some nice blues through here. There's not much clear sky in this scene. It's mostly full of trees and twigs, but put this in. It'll work really fast, but it's lovely while the sun is out. And this also helps to show you which bits are which in the composition, which bits are trunk and which bits are background. I'm using warm white, just create some light blue. Hoping it'll be a kind of soft tone. I'm using cobalt and French ultramarine here, and then some warm white to lighten it a little bit. Just put a little bit of medium in it, it's drying out a bit. Lime green. It's going to look really good with the bluebell colour later on. Can make up some cooler greens, deeper greens for the background. So that's warm white with bright green lake, a little bit of French ultramarine blue. It's a bit vivid, so put some unbleached detainer in there to take the brightness out of it. Squinting at it as I look. Some of the bright yellow lake in there for these distant leaves. And desaturate it a bit with the unbleached detainer. Hold it up for comparison. Squint through one eye and hold the brush up in front of the view. It helps you to get the tones and the colour right. brambles through them. I don't quite like that colour. Some burnt sienna in it. Try and dull it down a bit. I've got blue in there. I'll try and make this sit back in the painting a bit. It's a little bit bright, isn't it? Dab that off a little bit. It's bright in the wrong places at the moment. It's a bit softer, it's better. Work quickly before it rains. I'm trying to have the odd spot of rain. Yeah. Hopefully it will blow over. Just put these dull blue greens in. Better. I'll try and get some of the purple so. Just in case I have to dash off if it starts raining. So I'm using magenta and cobalt blue to start with. Mix that with some mixing white. Hinting at these spikes of blue. Particularly ones in the foreground where the stronger colour needs to be. and build up the trees a bit more. This is ultramarine blue, burnt sienna, and a warm white. So this warm grey of the tree.
she looks so much darker on those twigs when the sun comes out on them. Hope it's okay. Hello.
Hello.
You're right.
Saying hello. Good boy.
Much easier to finish the painting while I'm out here than to try and revisit it back indoors. I'm just adding more light to the sky, trying to add richness and interest to it. So it's more than a sketch, really.
really that. Right. I think I'm going to stop there. Just to show you how I'm getting this dappled shade on the bluebell leaves. Just using a dark green. This is ultramarine with bright green lake and a little bit of burnt sienna in it to make a warm dark green. And I'm just doing squiggly marks that are a little bit like the leaves of the bluebells. And I also want to get some light green in there. In between. I think I need it to be a little bit less bright, more of a bluish lightness, because it's the leaves are reflecting the daylight in the sky. And just put that in between with the same brush so you get a kind of blending of the colours slightly. I've done little dabs of purple for the flower heads. Mostly dark, and I'll put in some highlights on those in a minute. Just using the... This is a flat-headed filbert brush. So I can use that on its side. For these marks. A bit more of this light colour and a bit more of the blue. Slightly clunky, but I can refine it a bit as I go. It's lovely how they catch the light. Needs to be a little bit more yellow. It's also happening over here too. I think what I'll do is get the finer brush. This is an Egbert, something like that. Just to get these whippy leaves in. Various colours going on in here. Using bright yellow lake and ultramarine blue down here.
Put some dark green in for the stalks of the bluebells too. So this is ultramarine, bright green lake. And just darken it a little bit with burnt sienna. I have to do every single one, but it just little bits of focal point here and there will help to make sense of it. Looking more of the darks. That green. It's lovely when the sun's out. It makes everything look so much more interesting. Really do have to work quickly though, because it's a cloudy day. I don't think this is going to last. It's really warm when the sun comes out too, it's very cold otherwise. So it's just starting to rain now, so I'm going to stop. But I think I caught what I wanted to get there, and it was gorgeous when the sun came out. So I've worked on this painting again back at home. I've developed the background with lots of soft, pale, spring-like leaf colours, but very, very low in contrast. They vary in colour, but there aren't sharp lights and darks in the background, and that helps to keep it back. And it also helps to emphasise all the stronger contrasts and details in the foreground. I've added all these leaves and twigs and defined them a little bit more, and the trees as well. And down in the foreground, where the light was falling on the bluebells and the grasses and bluebell leaves here, I've developed that area a little bit more too, with a variety of greens and more tones in the bluebells themselves. And I've lightened the path a little bit, and keeping it kind of peachy and a warm colour of the soil there helps to complement the cool blues and purples and greens in the rest of the painting. Quite happy with that now, much happier than I was when I finished work on it yesterday. Feels like a full painting now, a complete painting. So you can see I've developed this one a bit further too. I've brought the sky in more. The sky came down further than I had it, and I've also increased the brightness of these foreground greens as well, which helps to give depth to the whole thing. And the bluebells themselves are actually standing out a little bit more in the foreground. Through the middle here.
I hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you again. Bye bye.